Now I'm going to explain to understand process of digestion. We are having three places of digestion. One is the mouth. Then food enters into the stomach. This is the food pipe, esophagus. This is the stomach. Then food enters into the small intestine for digestion. This is the small intestine. Then from here food goes to the large intestine. After that defecation. This is the whole process. Now try to think, this is the mouth, this is the stomach, this is the small intestine, this is the large intestine, this is the rectum passage, undigested food is going out. Now come to the point, this is the first place where mouth digestion is carbohydrate. Carbohydrate, with the help of amylase, it transforms into glucose. There are two activities of digestion. One is the mechanical, in which our teeth and gums and jaws help in crushing the food into pieces. That is mechanical digestion. After that, chemical digestion happens. There is enzyme amylase, amylase works on carbohydrate and converts carbohydrate into glucose. Therefore, when you eat rice alone, or roti alone, corn alone, do not take any kind of sausage. After some time when you chew, you will find some sweet taste, mild sweet taste. That is the transformation of glucose in the food substance into transformation of the carbohydrate into glucose. If you are eating potato with the sour ketchup, or rice, or wheat berry, anything, then digestion, chemical digestion will be disturbed. Then we are not using amylase enzyme. This is called ignorance. Okay, let us now decide from today. We are not going to have any sour things with the rice, roti or any grains in the mouth. But we are habitual. Our mind needs pleasure. We are not able to leave this habit. Do not worry. The reduced distance, body and mind, use all power of body, mind, intelligence, everything, how to reduce distance between body and mind, you will have dhrishtadyumna consciousness, yoga agni. Then you will have great power how to love habit. When you are able to love your habit, then you can change the habit. Otherwise, it will be like philosophy, oh, it is not possible, oh, I can't do it. Prefer to take medicine, eat whatever you enjoy. Therefore, mind is very powerful. Until mind is charged with the power of dhrishtadyumna, which having great power how to love habit, the mind is a slave of habit. You should remember it. This is the one point. When you are taking the food, after chemical digestion in the mouth, food travels into the stomach. It will stay here 2.5 years, 1/2 hours, 2 hours, or 2.5 hours. If you have not overstuffed it, you have eaten moderate, then 2 hours and 2.5 hours food will stay here. After that it will enter into small intestine. Here food will stay 4 to 6 hours. If little small quantity, 4 hours minimum, little more 6 hours. If overeating, it will take many hours more. When digestion is going on in here, in intestine, then there is no digestion in the stomach. This is that there are some hormones which suppresses the stomach digestion. But still within 2 hours you are eating again. You have eaten something, after 2 hours you are eating some chocolate, some laddu, something here and there. No problem. Then you have extra willpower. Your stomach will start working it. The stomach needs surplus life force. This is the general life force. For example, if you need 50 units, if you have eaten frequent eating, After eating 2 hours, again you are eating it. Your stomach heavy stress. In order to remove stress, the surplus life current is flowing from the spine to the stomach. Let us imagine 100 unit is surplus. This is the wastage of internal life force. This wastage, it creates poverty. We lose riches, vitality. This is very important. Therefore, minimum 4 hour gap should be there for those who are not eating too much. We have moderate 6 hours. Overeating is not allowed. Sometimes we have overeaten, you can increase little more gap. This is the general principle of eating. It is written in medical text. This was true 50 years before, this is true even now.